Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Salon for All and Voice for All Network Television. I am your host, Khadija Tijanabi. Interesting topic today, of course, when it comes to polygamy or relationship as a whole, relationship in a broad focus, obviously. As I know, 2 years back, to be precise, I mean, they do many relationship topic in a form of an audio, and we don't do few of them on this platform as well. And as the days they go ahead, we will continue for do many more on different part of it. Today we focus on polygamy and the religious aspect, the part of the religion within the religion permit in terms of Islam, and at the same time within we will say the millionaires or the billionaires that they use in terms of abusing the right as Muslim or because of their wealth, then they don't take an outside of the teaching of Islam. The people that we learn more pass away when our spiritual leader, one of which will come with me today, we get a lot of announcement for make, or they come right back and do so. But at the same time, I want also give a disclaimer. We are in terms of us here, we would come today in terms of our panelists, them, we are not perfect, we're not relationship expert, but I can always say we don't be in relationship, whether it's marriage or you don't go through your trials and tribulation in terms of relationship, those experience when the experts that they put together for them write a book or whatever the case may be, or give them survey or them in terms of what the man and think, the woman and think, obviously then gets the experience and they from the one they wouldn't go through. So hence the reason why we go use those experience and we speak on those experience. So again, but we just want to do that disclaimer day in advance, make a recognize or acknowledge some of you now we don't come in. Mr. Dauda Mahmoud Black, welcome, sir. So like I've been saying, sometimes I need to see in a either I go too fast or too slow. So you know, don't blame me, I beg you, and I forgive me. Now share when they come back. Hello, Mr. Idris Kabia, welcome, sir.
But it's all love, relationship topic. I couldn't run away, my eyes won't let me. I thought I was dreaming, but you stand right in my way.
And I welcome once again. Please share.
All my eyes can see is you. If this is love, my dear, welcome to my world. And let us share the good times together. It's only one world. Let's share it together. Hold on, my eyes can see. Is you my dear? I don't know if the sun will shine tomorrow.
Oh, welcome. All about relationship topic, where they change the dynamic a little bit. As in, I know we get different things that we can address on this platform. And they come back and make some announcements and go from there. Now, welcome once again. Please share. But they come right back.
Tomorrow, but I know my eyes never let me down.
Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Salon for All and Voice for All Network Television, where every voice matters. I am your host, Khadija Tijan Nabi. Always ready and determined to bring you current events from home and abroad. What to expect? Wide focus, a range of topics from political, family, relationship, empowerment, breaking news, both local and international, emergency topics, entertainment, both local and international, comedy, event affecting our various communities, political debate, educational session, exclusive interview with either local or international celebrities or high profile, showcasing up-and-coming artists, entrepreneurs, philanthropists. If it is happening, we're here to be that voice and the network to show it. If you have a story, let's share it, build it, and show it. Let us be your voice. Stay tuned to Salon for All and Voice for All Network Television for more. Do not forget to subscribe to our Facebook page, our YouTube page, our Instagram page, and our Twitter page. And also feel free to visit our website. We thank you all for being part of the Salon for All Network family.
It's Cammy, baby.
Special one, we're gonna make you happy and we're gonna love you truly. I'm not gonna able to explain, no, cause this feeling is so magical, very romantic. The way that you love me, baby.
I love you, that I know. From my crack to Freetown, them go see them bow down. We go with them hands down. Love you, that I know. From my crack to Freetown, them go see them bow down. We go with them hands down. Girl, you make me happy, but damn, I am so lucky. It is the same to a friend, yeah, baby, I'll come and make you happy.
Baby, you know. Now you love the sweet me heart in me. Oh yeah, baby, you know.
scare me, baby.
Your love, you dey keep us sane. You dey make her dey stagger like a drink poison. Yeah. That thing where you give me more. Baby, come on, I say non-stop. That thing where you give me more. Yeah, that thing where you show me, baby, I can't get enough of you, you. Like a drink poison. Yeah. That thing where you give me more. Baby, come on, I say non-stop. Yeah. That thing where you give me more. Yeah, that thing where you show me, baby.
What make you dance for me, baby? Oh, yeah, pull your panty for me, baby. I know you like plenty for it, daily. Better know me plenty, honey, daily. My own. With my human precious, buy you nice ship, buy you a Lexus, buy you a ship, buy you a resort. Girl, you want it or you want Lexus?
Baby girl, I really wanna elevate you. Make you shame the one, them with them be hate you. If you wanna catch fish, send the bait to. Baby, believe me, you go celebrate.
So many girls are coming and telling me so many things, but my baby telling me so many things for pulling me mind, but still I did it.
Oh, yeah. I welcome back to the game.
It's Rosie, baby. Now you call me Eugene. Baby, you know. So now you love the sweet thing, Martin.
Madam Juliet, welcome. Madam Rama Koroma, welcome. Mr. or Madam G B, welcome. Madam Christiana A, welcome. Madam C Bangura, welcome. Mr. Sequence Dumbe in the house, welcome, darling. Mr. Suleiman, Sylvanius Bangura, welcome. Hello, Mr. Alusain Bangura, welcome. Madam Mata Sise, welcome. Madam Marian, Madam Marian Williams, welcome. Madam Aisha P, welcome. Sorry, we get some interruption. I come right back. Now take a quick break while in. I enjoy the tune. I come right back.
It's Cammy, baby.
Sorry, I'll be getting a quick interruption. Let's do this all over again. The wonderful Madam Iman Ibrahim, United Kingdom. Welcome, darling. Madam Samai, love. Welcome. Love you right back, darling. Madam Aminata Bangura, welcome. Madam Ellen Conte, welcome. Madam Precious Silla, welcome. Madam Aisha Sisse, welcome. Madam Marian Williams. Good now. Madam Martha, she say welcome. Okay, I think so. I don't get most of you now. Nah. Anybody who I'm missing, nah, forgive me. That means I'm not seeing now. Free time. Now help me share. Oh, Mr. Nabi Yansane, welcome. Thanks for your kind words, Madam Sami. Love. Madam Ellen Comte, welcome New York in the house. Thank you for your kind words. Tinini, tinini, tinini. Madam Ruki Irene Blue, welcome, madam. Welcome. Anybody who I'm missing, I forgive me. Now welcome once again to Salon for All and Voice for All Network Television. Once again, I am your host, Khadija Tijanabi. Mr. Bobby Brown, I see you in the house. Welcome. Mr. or Madam Central Barbie, welcome, madam. Welcome. Madam or Mr. Bister Thomas, welcome. Welcome. And once again, welcome to Salon for All. I hope saying that they go well. Few announcements. Now we'll give a big shout out to Mr. DJ Raheem Sekunda from United Kingdom, which also celebrates another milestone today. Madam Isa 2K, welcome, madam. Where I believe say instead of the give back to Mama Salon in your little way, how we know in terms of entertainment, in the, you know, contributing to the entertainment industry. So again, with the celebrate, I'm here. We'll go play one of your favorite song in a little bit. So from Salon for All to you and your family, would I wish you all that you wish for yourself. Also, on the other community announcement, every one of you now where they celebrate but then at this platform today, where maybe we don't know where they celebrate with you and where they wishing and nothing but the best. There are so many flyers where they don't delay, unfortunately, from the birthday of His Excellency, the former President Valentine Stasa, and Ambassador Archie Collins, where they all celebrate a milestone. Honorable Siraji Rollins and Minister Ali Kaba also celebrate another milestone today, where they give himself a shout out. Where, like I say, all these flowers there for me don't come out a week ago in terms of the one that we don't celebrate already. But unfortunately, we get issue with delay with we graphic designer. So again, with a wishing and nothing but the best, with a pray that all that's in a wish for in herself come to light. I also been talk about, of course, with the educates we serve each other here in terms of keeping each other, as a reminder in terms of the coronavirus. I've been come across one, video where I will share with you in a little bit, when it comes to new medication. I think Sabi don't share with Tina again as one of the preventive measures that would take in terms of things that would drink just in case, just for protect yourself from this deadly pandemic. So I don't share at some points on my own personal page, Perseverance Tenacity. Maybe I will share them back again one of these day now the now with Facebook page, the Salon for All, where basically you they put things in together where they boil and drink. I come across a video where basically the same pineapple where we've been discussing at this platform and share also on my own personal Facebook page. They also use that same pineapple juice there for make nose drop, if I'm not mistaken, but I will play in a little bit. Madam Howard Mans, welcome. This person seems to be a bit suspicious, but we'll see how things go. In a little bit, we might have to exit you out of this page. Madam Asanatu W, welcome, madam. How Precious MK, connection. MK Sila, welcome. Madam Zainab Nahim F, welcome, madam. Love you the most, madam Yassin. Ibrahim. Okay, so now play that one. Now play that one first. Then I'll come back again and make another announcement, and then we go from there. Now see if I can locate that particular video there where they refer to. This is not all for help we serve, educate each other. Where we come through any material, we're going to be beneficial, so we will continue for sharing.
The power of a pineapple is tonight being harnessed to battle coronavirus. Researchers trialling a treatment using extracts from the sweet fruit that could spell a treatment and stop the virus spreading in our community.
This golden fruit could be our golden ticket to fight COVID-19.
We think this could be a very major step forward for both the virus and hopefully for this country.
Donning a pineapple cap, this is Professor David Morris. He and a team of researchers at the University of New South Wales are adapting Bromac, a cancer drug, to create a nasal spray using an enzyme from the humble pineapple to dissolve coronavirus proteins.
We think that treating this disease in the nose and throat with this simple medication using a nose spray should prevent it from spreading to other parts of the body. It should render the virus non-infective to people around that patient.
Scientists say the spray could provide relief from the worst of the virus's impacts, that it will limit the number of infections and the seriousness of the disease in people.
Our frontline workers also hoped to benefit, able to use the spray to protect themselves from the infection when exposed to COVID-19 patients. The drug is tonight being produced in Australia and in large quantities.
It would be possible to supply the world from Australia with this medication.
Patients will soon begin testing the spray.
We've had fantastic results so far with our live virus tests. We have to try to make things better.
Sally Guyte, Nine News.
And I welcome back. I hope Sedande will be beneficial to some of we out there. Anything we're having to do with something, we will be. We go help we away. We go help. Hello to you, the wonderful Mr. Hassan Mansour, United Kingdom in the house again. Madam Maria Tubangura, welcome, Madam. Madam Zainab Mans, welcome, welcome. Anybody else again? What I'm missing? Forgive me, please. So, like I've been say, hopefully this will come to pass in this one. We're going to try for make these drugs, and it will be a help to everybody out there for as a preventive measure, or the one that way they suffer from the deadly pandemic. Hey, the wonderful Pasheki in the house, welcome, sir. Get ready for one or two debates in a little bit, not today, but in the upcoming days, sir. And I welcome once again. The other thing, one of we wonderful fan Naya. So I do not know your name, but I'm gonna share this because I come to this is the power of social media. So the the topic we've been getting yesterday, and seeing I've been seeing, I telling us in between, we'll go for the get some fun hours, them or fun time. Wherein I've been share, oh boy, a video for the critic, the one the way they say they put me in the hater category. Like I say, I don't get to anybody who I hate. I love you for the sake of Allah. Even the one that hates me or the one that criticizes me, I believe say they're all not blessing I'm alive because they keep me on my toes. So one of the things that I share, I come across this interesting video where one of the fan or the viewers of this platform where he share, I think it's so hilarious. So I share them and give shout out to him. I don't know you, sir, but thank you for the love and thank you for taking your time for put together that video. And if you happen for watch today, please just come through this thread and tell me your name, so I'll give you a shout out. That was wonderful. So now share with Tina, then I will share back the actual video where I've been share here yesterday. They come right back. And then I think, I get today a full of fun until we don't do the Timini and the Mende yesterday. So today I think, I get the full of fun. So now till I forget the fun, the fan in, they come right back.
Hey, Madam Khadija, will not kill me with laughter.
Welcome back. I'm sure
me, I like this smile pass all the same. But I make the haters then die. May they die. Yes, they can be the number one, so I like them.
And I welcome back. It's so beautiful to see that you're able to put a smile on another person's face. A beautiful. So fan, member of this platform, thank you for taking time and also giving us a shout out here. Please let me know what's in your name so that we'll go give you a shout out. And then I'll play that actual one day what I've been doing yesterday. And then when they come right back, I think say Mr. Bansobi like that from the reaction.
Maria. Zauri moyo ganeria. Mariana.
Oh man, that one is good. God bless you too, Mr. Bobby Brown. Love you the most, Madam Jamila. Welcome, darling. Welcome. Oh man. Anyhow, on the serious note, what else I want to say? Well, that take me down. We get a lot for discuss. Like I say, the first part of it, we they try for bringing with spiritual leader, where it give way knowledge on the Islamic perspective. I come across a video where I believe say a billionaire where happened to fall under the category of being a Muslim, but waiting I do not disagree on that video was that a statement saying that he get money and he can basically marry as much wife as he want. I believe say Islam give up to 4 wives, but on this video it gets 6 wives if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, from which I can recall. And I guess like what they say, money, power, respect. That's why I put that on the flyer. So then it become now not another look at things on the Islamic point of view, but rather because he's a billionaire, then he forgets about the religion aspect, but rather about in wealth or in own desire. So I want to play down there, then I pause, then I try for bring with spiritual leader right away. For now, I ask him a few questions. Then from there now, we'll bring the panelists them. It's going to be an interesting topic as usual. But they come right back. As a matter of fact, I will share other different marriage videos them as well, providing if I'm able to get to a spiritual leader right away or not, then will they come right back. Now, thank you. Let me give us some tune first while I locate the actual video.
One fan on my code. Download from Higher Level 360.
Hardway Records.
One fan on the mix.
Baby, this your love, you dey keep us in.
No.
You dey make her stagger like a drink poison.
Yeah.
That thing where you give me more. Baby, come on, I say non-stop. That thing where you give me more. That thing where you show me, baby,
bang.
I can't get enough of you.
My woman sweet, my woman precious. Buy you nice jeep, buy you one Lexus.
Now me check it. I know with you I go better. I now go put you on keke. Baby. You know me chicken, now me check it. I know with you I go better.
I now go put you on keke. Baby.
Baby, this your love, you dey kill person.
No.
You dey make her stagger like a drink poison.
Yeah.
That thing where you give me more. Baby, come on, I said non-stop. That thing where you give me more.
Ned Nwoko has stated that he can marry wives as he wants because his religion permits it. Speaking in an interview, Nwoko stated that he is from a royal family, and as such, he is entitled to as many wives as he so desires. The Nigerian billionaire is known to have 6 wives, while the internet has seen pictures of just two of them, Layla and Regina. The remaining four have been shrouded in utmost secrecy. Well, one of Ned Nwoko's wives is Layla Nwoko, a Moroccan lady who has kids with a striking resemblance to the billionaire politician. It has been widely reported that Layla is the first woman Ned Nwoko got married to, but this is not true. In fact, Ned Nwoko already had four wives before he got married to Layla. Ned's first wife is a well-respected legal practitioner named Barrister Lily Nwoko. He loves her so much, even to the point that he named one of his facilities at his resort after her. The facility, named Lily House, is an exquisite monument in Idumajegboko, Delta State, which Ned built in honor of Lily. The eldest child and look-alike son of Ned Nwoko, Tarek, died at the age of 22 in 2014. Tarek, who lived with his family in London, slept and never woke back up after telling his friends the previous night that he was not feeling well. Police investigations also revealed that there was no foul play in his death. He was a soccer player and a student at North Staffordshire University in England. Tariq's mother is another one of Ned's wives. She is said to be from Morocco, just like Layla. Although not much is known about her, she reportedly lives with the rest of her kids at Ned Nwoko's house in London. Nollywood actress Regina Daniels is obviously one of Ned's wives, and she is the reason why he became popular. Like many polygamous homes, one would easily assume that jealousy exists between Ned Nwoko's wives. However, the reverse is the case. Ned Nwoko has managed to ensure peace exists in his home by treating his wives and children equally. When it comes to kids, Ned Nwoko has a lot of them. Although not certain, Julia Nwoko, who was born on the 23rd of September 1996, appears to be the eldest daughter of the billionaire. The rest of them include Naya Nwoko, Amir Nwoko, Hayat Nwoko, Maya Nwoko, and Munir Nwoko. Munir is Regina Daniels' son, and his birth was announced on June 29, 2020. Before Regina put to bed, there had been a lot of rumors and controversies about her pregnancy. In May 2020, however, the actress first confirmed that she was expecting her first child. So who is Ned Nwoko? Prince Munir Nwoko, popularly known as Ned Nwoko, is a Nigerian lawyer, politician, and businessman, born on December 21, 1960. Nwoko was born into the royal palace at Idumajegboko in Anioka North LGA, Delta State. He is also a Muslim. He obtained his first degree in law and history from the Keele University in Staffordshire, United Kingdom, and a master's degree in law at King's College, London. He has an honorary doctorate from the Commonwealth University College in Belize. Ned first began to trend online for his alleged marriage to the beautiful and young Nollywood actress Regina Daniels in 2019. Their marriage has no doubt remained a thing of controversy, largely due to their age difference. He has a mansion in his hometown, which is an architectural masterpiece and a tourist center as described by experts. Both the interior and exterior of the house is a combination of Arabian and Western designs, complemented with a royal traditional touch. It has an Olympic-sized swimming pool, tennis lawn, a zoo which has different species of weird animals such as crocodiles, ostriches, horses, sea eagles, monkeys, rabbits, and so on. The land portion of the mansion has fish ponds with 50,000 catfish and a poultry with about 5,000 chickens. His mansion is estimated to be worth a sum of 10 billion naira. He also has a fleet of expensive cars added to his landed properties.
Have you ever had a hard time?
And welcome back, welcome back. I will get the check with we in a little bit. Alaji Abdullah in a little bit. So the number I will get to you in a minute. Mr. Muhammad Jallo, welcome. So basically, as in I see, the man, the question is not, can he afford it? Because obviously it seemed like able to maintain the family well financially, and also obviously everybody happy. There's no competition. There's no unfair balance. Seem like everybody is so well to well satisfied. But then the question or the concern come in the where in is the spiritual aspect of it. With that said, are they putting a back on a pause? I go share some one or two fun videos then with Tina. Then they come right back as soon as I get the imam in. They come right back and we go from there. Now, thank you.
Just give me sign. Let me walk around.
My husband. See, we get past when they go to the little people want to start.
My husband.
So, stop salad. Stop salad. You good day, this woman.
Thank you.
Nonsense.
Polygamy, baby.
Why you dey hold me act when you know say you know want them? You dey like by me, you mouth fast like bubble bantam. You dey shake your head,